Some 2 weeks ago, I issued a rare formal warning to our participating states about tensions between Ukraine and Russia in the Azov Sea. And as Minister Mavrov has referred to, the two of us urged all sides to stop the tit-for-tat provocations and start talking. I also conveyed this message to the Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov in my bilateral meeting here in Milan. We also called for a renewed effort to resolve the crisis in and around Ukraine. It is with great sadness that we observe the continuing conflict in eastern Ukraine amid ongoing military activity and a very bleak humanitarian situation. Our civilian monitors on the ground and the sophisticated monitoring technologies we have deployed face disruptions, unfortunately, on a daily basis. Despite of this very challenging environment in which our monitors operate, they continue to facilitate these windows of silence. More than 1,000 so far this year, during which essential repairs to damaged civilian infrastructure can take place. The sides need to break the political stalemate and work to fully implement the Minsk agreements to which they have committed themselves.
The meeting in Milan exceeded my expectations. We were coming here, obviously, under the influence of the recent incident in the Sea of Azov, and no one could have predicted how much this will overshadow the meeting here and the results. What I see as a very positive was the understanding of the so many participating states that this is a unique platform and we need to use it to discuss about our problems, to offer our visions. So it was not a formal meeting at all. It was not an easy meeting at all, but we have moved the agenda forward on a number of issues, and this is why I said that Milan strengthened the relevance of the OSCE. If we did not have the OSCE, there would be no platform to discuss this issue. So no one says it's easy. There are different versions and different visions of the world, but we are sitting here in one room at one table and we are discussing this.
Pensiamo al conflitto per la regione del Nagorno-Karabakh tra Armenia e Azerbaigian, e qui c'è stato uno sviluppo proprio a Milano, in quanto proprio qui a Milano ieri i ministri degli esteri dei due paesi, di Armenia e di Azerbaigian, hanno adottato una dichiarazione congiunta in cui manifestano qualcosa che definirei di più di una semplice volontà di comporre pacificamente il conflitto, ma una vera e propria dichiarazione di intenti di farlo e di farlo nell'interesse della popolazione di questa regione, che rappresenta un elemento di contestazione e di divergenza fra le due nazioni principalmente in causa, l'Armenia e l'Azerbaigian.